Hey, it's Greg Harrelson here, and I want to talk about the getting the buyer off the fence. It just seems to be something that we are dealing with right now. We have all these buyers, they're contacting us, they're emailing us, they're looking at our property alerts and whatnot. We've shown their properties, and for some reason, they've even identified properties that they really like, and they're showing signs that they really like a particular one, but they're not moving forward. They're just on the fence. We even have those buyers says, I was waiting till after the election. Now it's after the election. They're still on the fence. You know, I was waiting till, you know, till the end of the year. Now it's the end of the year. They're still on the fence. We just have to understand that when people are on the fence, it just means that there's still some questions that remain unanswered. Now, when you hear that, that has nothing to do with whether or not you have answered all the questions that they've asked. What I have learned over 20 plus years is that when people are on the fence, it typically means they have additional questions, and in most cases, that they've never asked. Therefore, they don't have the answers, and that's why they're still on the fence. So I've written down some notes here. Number one, in order to get a buyer off the fence, you've got to understand that they have those questions that they've never asked, and you need to ask them. You need to say something like this. Hey, I can sense that you're just a bit hesitant, so you're just not sure whether or not you should make the move. Let me ask you this. What do you need to know that maybe we have not discussed already that would give you a little bit more confidence about moving forward? So what do you need to know? What additional information would be helpful that we have not discussed already that with that information, it might be able to answer some questions and help you decide whether or not you want to move forward or maybe you don't want to move forward? What haven't we discussed? And then they say, well, no, I think you've answered all our questions. Yeah, I understand, you know, and that's typically the case. But I do have, you know, just wondering, a lot of times there's things that are kind of in your mind that maybe you haven't asked. And I just wanted to kind of talk about those things. You know, are you afraid that the market's going to go down? Are you afraid that you can't afford it? In other words, try to stimulate this and get them to engage in this conversation. Pull it out of them. Getting them to talk, communicate, be transparent is the surest way to get somebody off the fence. The second thing is we do too much telling and not enough showing. So yes, we're telling them, oh, this is a great property. Oh, the market's great. You're going to do great in this property. You're going to love this property. So we do a lot of telling like that. You know, I'm paraphrasing. Of course, you're probably saying it in a much more eloquent way, but we do a lot of telling. And sometimes people don't need to be told anymore. I do believe we need to tell them, but sometimes we've gone too far on the telling side and not far enough on the showing side. So maybe you can actually, you know, pull up a CMA and show them like other properties that have sold so they can see with their own eyes that what you're suggesting is supported by the data. You're not just making this suggestion so you can make a quick sale, so you can make a commission. You can show them something. Maybe you could take the appreciation over the last 5 years or 3 years or 2 years or 10 years for properties like the one that they're thinking about buying and show them how well people have done when they've purchased similar properties. Show them appreciation. Show them how other people have been building wealth. Show them. Less telling, more showing for the person who's on the fence. The third one I have here, because I'm going to keep this video short, but the third one I have here is ask them to present an offer. See, a lot of times people are on the fence because they're waiting for us to ask them. I bet you some buyers are saying, well, my agent's kind of on the fence. They haven't really said I should buy it or not. I should not buy it, or we should make an offer. Or we should not make an offer. So consider that some people are on the fence because they're waiting on us to make a suggestion and say, hey, look, I just want to let you know, I suggest we move forward and make an offer. I mean, if we were to make an offer, you know, where would you think coming in at? Where would you like to come in at? What would that offer be? Well, if we were to make an offer, we'd probably offer $400,000. All right, well, why don't we do that? Why don't we just go ahead and present $400,000 and see what they say? They can always say no, and they can always say yes. But why don't we just throw it out and see exactly how they'll respond, and then we can navigate from there. Would you like to go ahead and make an offer at $400,000? That's another way to get people off the fence. And you don't have to be pushy if they say, oh, no, we're not ready yet. No problem. What I'm concerned about is there's too many times the real estate agent could suggest, and that is the very thing that the buyer was waiting on. So how do we get the buyer off the fence? We simply get them off the fence by asking them, by showing them, and then bringing up or asking and having conversations that you haven't had before. You've probably done really good at giving them a lot of information, but if they're on the fence, it's because they're still lacking something. It's an unanswered question the majority of the time. So go out there, put that to use. And if I can do anything for you, I'm Greg Harrelson. I coach agents all through South Carolina, North Carolina, and I sure would love to help you. Talk to you later.